Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. In this video, I want to talk about estimating a population mean and the requirements needed to build a confidence interval to approximate the population mean, mu. A point estimate is a single value or point used to approximate a population parameter. Parameter could be a proportion, could be a mean, could be standard deviation. We want to use unbiased estimators to do this. And the sample mean is the best point estimate for a population mean because it's an unbiased estimator. We use sample mean to build a confidence interval that estimates the true value of the population mean. And we should know the sample size necessary to estimate the population mean. We will, in future videos, do examples where we actually put this to use. But I wanted to show you in this video what the requirements are, and there's a couple of different things to consider here. That is, if you want to build a confidence interval, you may be given the population standard deviation sigma, or you may not be given the population standard deviation, and that determines which method you're going to use. If you are given the standard deviation for the population, we want to make sure that there's a simple random sample, that it's normally distributed or it has an n greater than 30, that the number of sample values are given, we need to know that, the sample size, we need to know the sample mean, and we need to know the population standard deviation, well that's given, and the confidence level so that you can calculate the critical value, and we need to know the margin of error. And if we know all that, we're going to take the sample mean and subtract the margin of error, and the sample mean and add the margin of error. So you may recall from just previously, we did this same kind of thing with a proportion, but now instead of using p hat, we're using x bar. And the margin of error formula for this is the critical value that comes from your confidence level, and then the population standard deviation divided by the square root of n. So that's if you do know the population standard deviation. If you do not know it, we still need a simple random sample. We'd like to know it's normally distributed or that it has an n greater than 30. We need to know the sample size. We need to know the sample mean, x bar. In this case, we're going to use the sample standard deviation, s, and the confidence level so that you can calculate the critical value. But the critical value here is going to be from the student t distribution rather than the normal z distribution. And we need to know the degrees of freedom. And the degrees of freedom are just df, abbreviated as df, and it's just n minus 1. So if you had a sample size of 10, your degrees of freedom are 9. And we'll explain that in a really brief video coming up. The margin of error you need to know. And then you can see that these two things look the same. Once we're done, we have the population, the sample mean minus e and the sample mean plus e. We just get E a little bit different because E is being calculated with that T value rather than that Z value, and we don't know the population standard deviation, so we're using S instead of the sigma, and then we still have the square root of N. This T distribution, once you get to 30 values, starts to look a lot like the standard deviation, standard normal distribution. So they do sort of start to merge, but when you have really small numbers, they don't match. And the t values tables are something I talked about in one of my videos about the guy from Guinness Beer, Gossett, I think his last name is, that created those tables. And we don't have a population standard deviation because maybe no population exists for that. Maybe you are testing 7 types of beer. And that's it. You've got 7. There's nothing to compare with the population. Your sample is it. And that's why we use the t-tables in that case. And so really, a lot of times, we have no way of knowing what a population standard deviation would be. So the t-tables come in really handy. I'll talk more about the comparison between the standard z distribution and the student t-distributions in future videos. So subscribe, so if you want to see those when they come up, you're ready to have that information. Have a great day.